Let us learn about file management in this video. File is a collection of data that is stored on a secondary device like a hard disk. A file is a simple text file. We can just create it using a notepad. You can open it and you can just write the numbers or whatever you want to write inside the file. And this is called as a file. So here I have saved the name of the file as file1.txt. So the extension of a file will be file1.txt, as you can see here. This portion where the input can be fed into the program and the output can be seen, that portion is called as the terminal. This is the area through which we give the input to the program usually. Now, what is the advantage of using a file? So we saw that it is very difficult to give huge amount of data through the terminal. For example, if you are asked to enter say 1000 numbers, that will be very difficult to enter through the terminal. Then second time if you are running that program again, it will be very difficult for you to give that same set of numbers again. So it is easier to store that in files. Then we know that the data that is given on the terminal, once you exit from that, then it will be lost. So files will store this data permanently. So these two are the advantage of using files, or it can be also the use of files. Now there are different file operations that we have to study. We will study each one of them. So before that, we have to just think of a file as a kind of a book. Okay, the file can be considered as equivalent to a book, and we have something called as a file pointer. So you can just consider it as equivalent to a bookmark. So while you are reading a book, you will be keeping a bookmark in order to know where you have stopped, and it will be just pointing to the page where you have stopped. So similarly, you have a file pointer that is associated with every book or every file. And that will help you to open, read, write or close the file and do everything related with that file. So first of all, you have to create a file pointer in all the programs of files. So that is written using this syntax, that is file pointer. So the word file has to be capital letters, and star shows that it is the file pointer. It is a pointer, so it is represented by star. And then you have the name of the file pointer followed by the star. And then you will put a semicolon. So this file pointer will point to the structure inside standard input output header file, and that will contain all the information about the file. Now, if we have to write something in a book, then we will be opening the book before we read or write the book. So similarly, a file has to be opened before you read or write into that file. So it is written by, the syntax of that is given by the file pointer name. So first you would have declared that file pointer. You have created that file pointer here. So here you have to now write that file pointer name equal to sign followed by F open. So F shows that it is file and followed by open. Then you have within double quotes, you're going to write data.txt, which is the name of the file, followed by in which mode that you are going to open that file. So once you open the book, that book could be in you are actually opening that book to write something or opening that book to read something. So which mode that you are opening, that you have to specify to the computer. So that is represented within double quotes. So let's see the different modes of opening. So we have already seen W. So W means to write, and it creates a new file if there is no previous file that is existing, and it opens an existing file if such a file is already present, and then it will discard the previous contents and it will start writing from the first. Whereas you can open a file also for reading, then whatever contents are there in the file, you can read from that. You won't be able to write to that file. Then generally when you're opening your notebook, you would have stopped somewhere, then you would have to add your notes starting from some point. So this appending means adding to where you stopped. So A, if you're going to open the file in A mode, it means you're going to append to that file. That means you can start from where you stopped writing. Then R plus, W plus, etc. is also used to read to and write to. Okay, you can do both the functions. Then A plus is append plus, so there you can read and write to the end of the file, that is from where you stopped. Now suppose if such a file does not exist, then while you open the file, you'll probably see some, you have to get some error message. So that has to be written within your program. So let's see how this can be done. So first of all, we'll write hash include stdio.h, then we have void main. Then we create a file pointer, and that is done using capital letter word called file, followed by a star, and then you have fp, which is the name of the file pointer. Then in order to open the file, we write fp, that is the name of the file pointer, equal to fopen, that is file open. Then this is the name of your file, that is data1.txt, and that is opened in which mode? It is opened in write mode. So if that file pointer does not point anywhere, that means null means it is not pointing anywhere. So suppose if you're able to open it properly, then it will be pointing to some location, some memory location. If that is not possible, then it will be pointing to null. So if that file pointer is pointing equal to means you're checking if that file pointer value is equal to null, then it means that there is an error in opening the file and you have to show that error to the user. So printf, there is an error in opening the file. And then you can exit from the program by using exit 0. So this is a function that will stop the entire program and it will exit from that program. Else, if the file pointer has been able to open, it is not a null value, it is pointing to somewhere, then you can do the necessary program inside this else function. So once you open a book, you read or write into it, then generally after you finish doing whatever it is, you will close the book. So this is done by, similarly for a file, you have to close that file once you are done with all the operations. So after all the necessary steps are done, then you have to close the file, and it is done by fclose fp, where fp is the file pointer name. So understand here that the opening and closing all is related with the file pointer, and that is very important. And once that file is closed, if any buffers or any temporary storage has been used in association with that file, all that gets cleaned up by the computer. In order to read and write to the file, we have some standard input and output functions for that. So we have certain read functions and we have also write functions as given here. So all these functions have the letter F in front of them to show that it is a function of the file. Now, let's study how to scan input to a file. While you're using scanf, then we've already seen that in the terminal we'll enter the numbers. Those numbers using scanf, we will take it into the program. For example, if you're finding the sum of two numbers, then we will enter the two numbers, say 2 and 3 in the terminal. They will be read using scanf and that will be scanned to the program variable, say A and B. So here, fscanf is similar to the scanf statement. The only difference is that from the text file, there we will have the values, and those values will be read using fscanf to the program, to the various variables. So it is very similar to scanf. The only difference is that in scanf, we'll be reading from the terminal. In fscanf, we'll be reading from the file. So the syntax of fscanf is same as that of scanf. The only difference is that in front of fscanf we will have the file pointer. So the name of the file pointer, if suppose it is fp, then that you have to write followed by a comma. Then you have the control string and the variables. In front of that you have the ampersand sign. So everything that is same as that of an ordinary scanf. The only difference is that you have a file pointer name in front of it followed by a comma. So let's see how to read numbers from a text file and print it onto the terminal. For example, what we are going to do is, say I have a file called numbers.txt, and inside that I have many numbers inside it. So these numbers will be read one by one into an array called as num, and this num has to be printed onto the terminal, the ordinary terminal where you see the output. So this will be your output. So first, using fscanf, we will read it onto the array called num, and then using an ordinary printf statement, we will print it onto the terminal. So let's see how to do it. So you have got hash include stdio.h void main. Then this is how the file pointer is created. Then we are going to declare a few variables including an array. We are going to open the file called numbers.txt in read mode, because you are only going to read from that file. The numbers are already present inside that file. Then we are going to check if there is any error in opening the file. If there is any error, we are going to exit from that. Then next we are going to check, using a for loop, we are going to check if it has reached the end of the file. Whether the file pointer, after reading all the numbers, it has reached the end. That is called as f, end of f. That is, f stands for, it is to show that it is a file function, and e of f stands for end of file. End of file. So f end of f is a keyword, and within that bracket you can write the name of the file pointer. So it is not reached that end of file pointer. Till there it will keep on reading all the numbers, and it will scan using the file pointer onto the array called numbers.txt. So since these are all integer numbers, we want to assume that the file has got all integer numbers. All those numbers are read into the array called num, and using a simple for loop and a printf statement, we are going to print the numbers one by one onto the terminal. Once the program is over, we have to close the file using the file pointer. Now, how can we print the output or write onto a file? So we saw that how to read from a file using a fscanf. So next, what we are going to do is an fprintf, which will help you to read from that, which will help you to write onto that file. So from the program, you are going to write it onto that file. So one by one, you will be writing onto the file. So this is done using fprintf. You are going to print to the file. So this is your file. So this also has got a similar syntax like that of a printf. In front of this, you will be writing fp, which shows that it is a file pointer, and followed by the same syntax as that of printf. Now let's see an example of fprintf. So you can actually check the error. I have not done that for this program. So here the question is to write a string to a file called file.txt. So let us imagine that string is hello, and that hello has to be written onto the file.txt. So that is your text file. So hash include stdio.h, you got created the file pointer called fp. Then you're going to declare an array called x, a character array, and the size you are not mentioning, so that is why you are going to put a simple bracket here, and you are going to input hello into that array. Once x gets the value hello, you're going to open the file in write mode, and fp is equal to fopen file dot text. You can just open it in just w mode also, no problem. I've written here w plus, then fprintf fp. Fp means that is the name of the file pointer, followed by it is a string that you're going to print onto it. So percentage s, then the name of the string. Then once the job is done, what you will do is you will close the file using fclose fp. So once this program is over, hello will be written onto this text file. Next is to read the various characters from a file. So you can read one by one character, and that is done using fgetc. It is similar to getc what we have studied in module 2. So it reads just one character at a time. So since we are going to read it one character at a time, we'll have to use a loop, because a file will be having many characters. So you have to use a loop in order to read each character by character till you reach the end of the file. So this is the syntax of that. You'll write a character name is equal to fgetc f pointer, file pointer. So imagine you have a file, and that file name is file.txt. Inside that file, you've got a number of characters which is written one below the other, and then you're going to read it onto a character called q. Q is a character, and then this is done using fgetc. So q variable will get the character, first character, it will print it onto the terminal, then the second one, third one, and so on. So every character you read it onto Q, then that time itself you will have to print it onto the terminal. So file star fp, you are creating the file pointer. Then here it is not integer, it is actually char q. Then fp is equal to fopen file dot text. File dot text is the name of the file. You are going to open it in read mode. You're just reading the values from it until the end of the file is reached, while not f e of f. Okay, till the end of the file is reached, using a loop, you're going to read one character at a time. So q is the name of the variable. Q will get the value, whatever is the first character, q will get that using fgetc, and then you're going to print it onto the terminal. So this is used to print it onto the terminal. The output, you have to view it. So that is done using an ordinary printf. And using f end of f, we are going to check if you have reached the end of the file. And once the end of the file is reached, then you can write f close fp. That is, the file can be closed. Next is how you can write characters to a file. So we saw how to read character from a file. So next will be to write character by character onto a file. So there is a file here, and onto the file you're going to write one below the other, we are going to write the characters, and this is done using fputc. So fputc will write only one character at a time, and this is the syntax for it. Then for example, let us study an array is to be written onto a file called char.txt till the end of the array is reached. So we know that every character array has the last element as /0. So till that is reached, you have to keep on writing onto the file called chars.txt. So this is the name of the file, chars.txt. You're going to write the characters one below the other into it. So you have a character array, char array equal to hello. We don't have to specify the size. You can just leave a blank square bracket. It will automatically get the size. Then int I, that is a variable that is declared for the for loop. Then you have fp is equal to fopen. Chars.txt, you're going to open it in write mode. As I told you, w is also enough. Then for I equal to 0, array I, till the end of that array is reached, you have to see that the entire array is copied onto the file. So till the end of the array is reached, you will continue this. You're going to put every character by character of array onto the file called cars.txt using the help of fp, which is the file pointer. So once this is done, you can use fclose fp. So don't forget that. Next is reading the lines from a file. So in order to get one character by one character is very difficult and it is also not very efficient. So we can use fgetters, which will read a single line, okay, from one end to another. A single string can be read, and this is the syntax for it. So let's see one by one. So in the syntax, this is the name of the array where the line will be stored. So once you read it, you have to store that array. So that array will be array name. And 80 is the maximum number of characters that you're going to read in this line. So you'll have to specify what, say, 80 or 60 or whatever is the maximum number of characters that it has to read from that file and store it onto array name. And finally, you have fp, where fp is the name of the file pointer. So let's see an example of fgetters. So you're going to declare file star fp, then you have a string which can store up to 80 characters. Then you're going to open the file called more.txt in read mode. You can give any name to your file unless and otherwise it is mentioned in the question. You can give any name to it. Then it has to have just .txt as the extension. If fgetters string, 60, fp is not equal to end of the array, then we will put that onto string. Once the job is over, we will close the file. So let's see what is this string. String will store the value that is read from more.txt onto string. Then we have 60, which shows that the maximum number of characters that need to be read from more.txt is only 60 characters. Even though string can store up to 80 characters, we prefer that only the first 60 characters be read onto it. Then fp is the name of the file pointer. So using this method, 60 characters will be read from more.txt. 60 characters will be read and that will be stored into a string called str. So that is what we have done, and this is done using fgetters. Next is how we can write lines to a file. So instead of fgetters, we have fputs, which will help you to write it onto the file. So here, fputs array name fp, this is the syntax, where array name is where the line is stored, which you have to input onto the file. So here you have an array called x, and that x will contain hello. So here you need a square bracket. X will contain hello. And in file.txt, what you have to do is that file is opened in write mode. And this value that is stored in x, you're going to write it onto file.txt. So for that, this is the syntax fputs. So x is the name of the array which will have the value hello, and fp is the file pointer. Then you can close the file. Next, you have unformatted read and write. Unformatted read means it can read from binary file, or it can read a bulk amount of data from a file. So you're not specifying the number of characters, or you're not specifying how much you're going to read. So bulk amount of data can be read, and this is called as unformatted read. So this is the syntax of it: int fread, str size, num and fp. So let's see each one of them. String is used to point to a block of memory, and the size is the size in bytes of each element to be read. This is the size. Next one, Next is num is the number of elements, and finally you have the file pointer. So this can be used to read anything like integer, data, character or string. You don't have to bother about the control string over here. All this can be read using this bulk type of reading using int fread. Similarly, you have fwrite. Fwrite is unformatted write to the file. So just like what we saw in the previous slide, all those are same. It is only that you're going to write it onto the file. Next, you have fseek. So fseek means if you have a file, you want to go to a particular position. If you have to place that file pointer over there, then you can use fseek. So fseek will have 3 arguments. So this is fp, which is the name of the file pointer. And offset is the number of bytes to the offset from, that is the, it will actually show a kind of a position. And the finally is where that position has to be, whether it has to be in the beginning or whether it has to be the current position of the file pointer or whether it has to be the end of the file. So these are the 3 values that where can take. So where is the position, actual position of where it has to be placed. So seek set, seek current and seek end, where it represents the end of the file. So these are the 3 values that where can take. Offset means from that position how many bytes it has to move. For example, if it is in the current position of fp, then I'm saying that it has to move 4 bytes. That is where it is supposed to be present. So that is what is represented by offset. Next you have ftel. Ftel is the function returns where the current position of the file pointer. So where the file pointer is standing, that current position will be returned by ftel. So length will be the value which shows the current position. If a 1 is returned, then it shows that it is an error. Then length will be the position where the file pointer is actually placed right now. It will be given in terms of an integer. The last one is f end of file. We've already seen that f end of file, f stands for file. We've already seen that the last one is f end of file. We've already seen that f end of file means f indicates that it is a file function. E O F stands for end of file, and then within brackets you have to write the file pointer. So this will give a non-zero value when end of the file is reached. Otherwise, it will give a zero value.